Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Paul from TechLink and today's video will be another quick tutorial in which I want to show you how to create a new chat group in Signal Messenger app. Now, Signal Messenger has become very popular among smartphone users mostly because of its focus on privacy and security. The chats are end-to-end encrypted, which means that no one can see the messages that you send or receive from other users. At this point, you might be thinking, well, WhatsApp is encrypted as well. That's true, and in fact, both of the apps use the same encryption protocol. But what makes a big difference between the two of them is the ownership. While WhatsApp is owned by Facebook, Signal is being developed by a non-profit, which means that the company is supported by donations, so they don't need to sell ads or user data like Facebook would do in order to survive or expand. And that's one of the main reasons people tend to prefer Signal over the most popular WhatsApp, because of its enhanced privacy. Now, back to the group chat feature. Just like in the regular conversation in the app, Signal doesn't hold any data of your group memberships, group titles, avatars, or group attributes. In order to create a new group, you have to launch the Signal app on your iPhone and tap this pencil icon at the top right corner of your screen, and now you select the new group. After that, you need to add members to your group, so you can select the contacts that you would like to include, or if you want to add someone who is not on your contact list, you can do that by entering their phone number. After that, press next, and for the last step, insert a group name, and if you want, you can add a group photo, but this is optional, so it's up to you if you wish to do so. Then just, let's say we call the group technical, press create, and that's it, you're done. That's all you have to do. Just like on WhatsApp, you can invite members via a group link or QR code. You have admin controls to edit group info or remove members, but there are also some differences like the group members limit. You can add up to 1,000 members, which is a lot more than what you can add on WhatsApp. Also, when you add someone, they won't automatically join the group. They need to accept your invitation request before they can participate in the group. And that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed it and found it useful, please give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to see some similar videos or more tech-related content, please subscribe to the channel. And like always, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.